What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how to jailbreak iOS 12.5.7 with no computer needed, and this is an extremely easy process to do in 2024. So let's just go ahead and get right into it. Now the first thing you guys want to check is to make sure your software is on iOS 12.5.7. If your device is the max version supported by iOS 12 and it's not on 12.5.7, you can just go ahead and update it all the way to 12.5.7 and this will work perfectly. In fact, it'll even be more secure. So if you're not on 12.5.7, go ahead and get to 12.5.7. If so, we can continue with the tutorial. So the first thing we need to do is head into Safari and then we're gonna go ahead and search up ipa-apps.me. And you'll see right there, we can go ahead and tap go now. And now once you're on the site, we're gonna scroll down just a little bit and you will see Freya right here. That is the one that we are going to use. However, if you want to, you are able to use Chimera, which goes up to 12.5.7 as well. But for this tutorial, we are going to use Freya, which is right here. So once you're there, just go ahead and tap get. There might be ads that pop up, just close out of them. And you can see this time it takes me to a thing where I have to wait a couple seconds. Then we'll tap skip this ad. Close any ads that open up and tap it again. And here we go. You see it has our little prompt here. We're going to tap install and head back to the home screen. Now with this method, it is pretty rare to get revokes. If that does happen, I will show you what to do. And you can see for me, it installed perfectly. But if you do end up having an issue to revoke, the way that you're going to fix it is by going into settings and then scrolling down until you see Safari. Once you got Safari, scroll down once again and you will see clear history and website data. You just do that. And then when you try to install it, everything should be cleared and it should work. Now, since it didn't have a problem for us, we're gonna go ahead and close out of settings so that it's all cleared out and you'll see Freya right there. If we try to go into it right now, it's gonna throw an untrusted certificate at you. So what we need to do is go back into settings and now it'll be all cleared out. Go down to general. And you see at the bottom of this page, we're gonna have a profiles section. We're going to go into that and then trust it. Once you got that, we can go out of the settings app and we can now go into Freya. And you'll see in Freya, we're going to have a jailbreak button right here. And that is what we are going to click. And you can see it says my snapshot has been renamed and it's going to reboot the device. So we'll go ahead and tap OK. And we can go in and go back in, swipe one over, and you'll see Freya's still there. We go back in. And now we will click jailbreak once again. And we are now back in, and if we swipe over to the right, you will see we have Cydia right there on the screen. Now we are not done just yet. We do want to go into Cydia and make sure that everything is up to date. Just allow the sources to refresh. And then tap return to Cydia. You're gonna see it has an upgrade here. We're going to do a complete upgrade to make sure everything is secure, then confirm. Then tap return to Cydia, and we can now close out of it. So your phone is now completely jailbroken, but I do want to show you what will happen if you reboot the device or if it dies or anything happens to it where it turns off and back on. And I'm not talking about sleep mode, of course, but I'm talking about if it gets turned off all the way and turned back on. How do you re-enable the jailbreak after that? That is what I will show you now. And now after rebooting, we're gonna see over here we have Cydia, but we're not gonna be able to actually open Cydia because it is not in a jailbroken state. So to solve this, we're gonna go back into Freya, and you'll see at the bottom, this time it says enable Freya and not jailbreak. And you will see it says it has enabled the jailbreak and you can go ahead and respring it. And now we're back in, so we can go ahead and go over and see. Cydia is back there, and you can see it is back to normal working order. So Cydia is working perfectly, and you can go ahead and do whatever you want with it, install whatever tweaks, themes, anything you want, because your device is now fully jailbroken. So guys, if you liked that video, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel, because I make lots of content like this that'll help you with your jailbreaks and tons of tech videos in general.